Hachette Audio presents Legends in Sports, Kobe Bryant. Written by Matt Christopher with Glenn Stout. Read by Cary, Hite. Chapter 1. 1978 to 1983. Jellybean goes to Italy. If you look in the 1983-1984 edition of the official National Basketball Association register, you can find the complete career statistics of Joe Jellybean Bryant. Nothing in the record of the 6'9" and 1/2 inch, 215-pound center forward really stands out. It states that he graduated from John Bartram High School in Philadelphia and attended LaSalle College for 3 years, averaging just over 20 points per game in 2 seasons of basketball. In 1976, he left school and was selected in the first round of the NBA draft. From 1976 to 1983, Jellybean, who earned his nickname after some young fans gave him Jellybeans following a game, played with the Philadelphia 76ers, San Diego Clippers, and Houston Rockets. He had a solid career in the NBA, averaging 8 points a game and earning a reputation as a fine passer and a defensive specialist. But Bryant wasn't quite big enough to play center full-time and didn't shoot quite well enough to play forward. He was wonderfully athletic, but in some ways he was ahead of his time, for his flashy style of play wasn't much appreciated in the NBA 3 decades ago. He was a role player who left the spotlight to teammates like future Hall of Famers Elvin Hayes and Julius Erving. None of his teams ever won an NBA championship, and Bryant never made an All-Star team. Yet, none of that begins to measure Joe Bryant's contribution to the NBA. For in the long run, Joe Bryant may have left a greater legacy to the NBA than many of its better-known stars. That's because Joe Bryant is the father of the Los Angeles Lakers, Kobe Bryant, one of the youngest and brightest stars in the NBA, a player who joined the NBA directly out of high school. The son's career has eclipsed that of the father. Kobe Bryant has already been an All-Star, won the NBA Slam Dunk Contest, and won an NBA championship. His story began when his father's NBA career came to an end. After the 1982-83 NBA season, Joe Bryant's career was at a crossroads. After 8 seasons in the NBA, including 3 years as a starter for the Houston Rockets, Bryant had become a second-string player. He had settled into a backup role on the Rockets, who had finished with a record of 14-68, the worst record in the league. That finish gave them the right to select 7'4" center Ralph Sampson, the best player in college basketball, in the NBA draft. That may have been good news for Rocket fans, but it wasn't very good news for Joe Bryant. Now that they had Sampson, the Rockets didn't really need Bryant. So at the end of the season, the Rockets released him. No other team in the NBA expressed much interest in signing the veteran, preferring to stock their rosters with younger and cheaper players. At age 28, it appeared as if Joe's career as a professional basketball player had come to an end. The popular Bryant probably could have gone into business in Houston, but he and his wife Pam, also a Philadelphia native, decided to return home. Bryant quickly discovered that he missed the game of basketball. But he didn't want to coach or anything like that. He still wanted to play. Fortunately, Bryant was a good friend of a man named Sonny Hill. Hill ran a well-known summer league in Philadelphia and had contacts throughout the basketball world. He told Bryant about a unique opportunity to keep playing the game he loved. Although basketball had been invented in the United States, the game had spread all over the globe and was probably the world's second most popular sport after soccer. Several European countries even supported their own professional leagues. Like all pro sports leagues, they were always on the lookout for talent. And the United States was still the home of the best basketball players in the world. Representatives of the Italian Professional League had contacted Hill and told him they were in the market for some talented American players. They paid well and played a much shorter, easier schedule than the NBA, usually with only 1 game a week. Hill told Bryant he should consider playing in Italy. When Bryant said he was interested, Hill put him in touch with the Italians. Bryant was precisely the kind of player the Italians wanted. His NBA background, size, and skills were guaranteed to make him a star in the Italian league. Moreover, his effervescent personality was certain to make him a crowd favorite. Bryant was intrigued, and not just because it meant he could keep playing basketball. When Joe had played in the NBA, he'd spent a lot of time on the road. He sometimes went a week or more without seeing his family. Joe and Pam were the parents of three young children. Their oldest daughter, Sharia, was 7 years old. Sister, Shaya, was six. And Kobe, named after a special type of steak and born on August 23, 1978, was five. While Bryant still held out some hope of returning to the NBA, he worried about the effect such continued absences would have on his family. The more Joe and Pam discussed the possibility of moving to Italy, the better it sounded. The money was good, and the lighter schedule meant he'd be able to spend a great deal of time with his family. In addition, they thought that living in Italy and traveling around Europe would be a wonderful opportunity for their children to experience a different culture. They decided to accept the offer and move to Italy. Kobe Bryant's basketball education was ready to begin. Chapter 2, 1984 to 1991. His father's son. The Bryants packed up their belongings and moved to Rieti, Italy in 1984. While Joe Bryant was learning the ins and outs of Italian basketball, and Pam Bryant was finding her way around a new city, Sharia, Shea, and Kobe, who had just turned six, started attending an Italian school. Surprisingly, the Bryants' three children had a relatively easy time adjusting to their new culture. Children are adept at learning new languages. Although they didn't understand a word of Italian when they began school, as Kobe later explained, "My two sisters and I got together after school to teach each other the words we had learned. I was able to speak Italian pretty well within a few months." Joe Bryant experienced a similarly quick transition to basketball Italian style. On his Italian team, he was the go-to guy, the player who was supposed to score points and entertain the fans. He thrived in the somewhat less competitive league. Few players could match his blend of size and quickness. He averaged over 30 points per game and wowed the crowd with dunks, long jumpers, and no-look passes. In a matter of weeks, he became one of the league's best-known and most popular players. The fans even made up songs about him, claiming he was a better player than NBA stars like Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. The family loved their new life. They enjoyed traveling around Europe to see such sights as the Roman Colosseum in Italy and the Eiffel Tower in Paris. They also enjoyed the opportunity to experience new cultures. In much of Europe, for example, people don't buy all their food at grocery stores. Instead, they often shop at outdoor markets full of fresh fruits and vegetables. But for the Bryants, the best part of living in Europe was the fact that the entire family got to spend so much time together. Although they faced little prejudice in Europe because of their African-American heritage, it was still difficult, particularly at first, for them to make friends. So they turned to one another for strength and company. Kobe loved being around his father. He went to many of his games and loved seeing the way the crowd reacted to his father's spectacular play. He often played basketball with his father and his sisters, and at 6 years old, could already dribble and shoot. Kobe's grandparents were always sending the family packages filled with videotapes of American television shows and movies that were impossible to see in Italy. Usually, they included a large number of tapes of the NBA, which at that time was only rarely broadcast in Europe. Kobe loved sitting with his father and watching the tapes of games. As they watched, Joe analyzed the play and explained what was happening on the court to Kobe. It was as if Kobe was attending his own private basketball school. Of all the players Kobe watched on the tapes, his absolute favorite was guard Irvin Magic Johnson of the Los Angeles Lakers. The 6'9" Johnson led the champion Lakers, and his unique combination of skills took the game into a new era. For despite his size, Johnson played point guard and proved that skilled, taller players can be just as adept at guard play as smaller men. Kobe watched the tapes of Johnson over and over again.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.